Hello everyone, I hope you all are fine and enjoy learning with us. I, Pankaj Chawla, once again I am here to share knowledge with you. Today I am going to share a well-defined MATLAB code to spot the effect of PID on the control system. In the previous class, we were discussed about PID and one of the methods to evaluate step response in MATLAB coding. To see the effect of PID on the system, we consider this numerical problem to define the function of plant and feedback. So here we go to start today's class. Once you open a MATLAB, open a script file to work over here. We simply adjust these windows so we can work in different windows simultaneously. Start writing code in an editor window with some basic command like clear all, clc to clear command window, then use tf command to initialize s variable. Then we have plant name variable to define the function of plant like 1 upon s square plus 3s plus 1, and feed name variable to define feedback equal to 1. Then use tfp name variable to calculate the transfer function of the system using command feedback like feedback plant into feed comma 1. Then use step command to evaluate step response and simply run this code, and here we have a step response of the plant that we considered today for our study. As we spot, the rise time of the system on a graph is approx 2.59 seconds. Rise time means how fast the system responds. As we discussed that the proportional controller use to change the response speed of the system. So are you ready to see the effect of PID on this system? Let's include it. I wanna create a separate space in the code for PID just by inserting a double percentage sign. Then initialize kp equal to 2, ki equal to 0, kd equal to 0 initially to see the effect of proportional controller on the system. Next, use the controller name variable to define the PID controller using the command PID like PID kp, ki, kd. PID is inbuilt function defines the definition of PID in MATLAB library. Then again use feedback command to evaluate transfer function of the system with controller and assign in tfpc name variable with controller into plant into feed comma 1, and use step command to evaluate step response of the system with controller by again run the same file, and here we have a step response of the system with controller. Now spot the rise time on this graph also, and this time we have rise time equal to 1.58 seconds. So that's the effect of P controller on the system, that rise time is improved. If we wanna see both responses on a graph with and without a controller, so use hold on command over here and run the file again to observe the step response of the system with and without a controller on a single graph like this. Blue color line represents system response without a controller, and orange color line represent response with a controller. Now if we like to see more effect due to the PID controller with continuously changing the value of the variable, it can be done easily as select the value we want to change and then right click on that. We have a list of options in which the first option is increment value and run section. Select it. It provides an interface to change the value and run this section only. This used to decrement the value and this used to increment the value of selected constant by 1. Now by simple click on the plus sign to change the value of kp by 1 and spot the effect on the graph as we continue to change the value by 1 and the rise time of the system improved, but the system get overshoot higher and higher with every increment. We do this till kp equal to 20. At kp equal to 20, we spot the rise time and it become 0.381 second, which is more better for the system as compared to system without controller. And now close the graph and run the file again to obtain a response to spot the effect of kp equal to 20 on the system. So this now clear observation between two with and without the controller. But now as we spot that the system get overshoot by 33.6%, so we discussed a derivative controller with a proportional controller help to the system to overcome the problem of overshoot. So we wanna change the value of KD by select the constant of it, and the same interface helps to increment it also like this. As we simply observe that with the increment of value of KD, overshoot gets reduced. We do this till KD equal to 8. At this value, response of the system is very near to its final value and overshoot is no more present in the system. Once again, close the graph and run the file to spot the clear effect of the PD controller on the system, that the system response is much better than the response of the system without controller. And again, I like to measure the rise time of the response, and this time it's equal to 0.269, so it is good. But now if we spot the steady state value of the system, a response without controller gives final value equal to 0.5. It means there is a steady state error near about 0.5, and the response with controller gives 0.952, that is a steady state error is near to 0.048 only. But as we discussed, the integral controller along with the PD controller reduces the steady state error and helps the system to maintain at its final value. So this time change the value of KI using the same interface and see the effect of PID controller on the system. As we achieve final value equal to 1 for the response, so this PID now tuned for this system. So close the graph and run the file to see the final response of the system without and with the controller. So we can easily notice the change in the response due to the effect of PID. Now if we wanna see how PID inbuilt function define PID in the MATLAB library, so you can get it by variable name which you use to define it, as in our case type controller on command window and enter. You get the same equation which we discuss theoretically, that is KD plus KI upon S plus KD into S, and it also indicate the value of KP, KI and KD which are we finalized during the tuning of PID for the system. So in this way you can tune PID manually for the system, but there are many algorithms to optimize the value of PID for a particular system. We may also discuss some method to tune PID with the help of optimized technique in further classes. Till keep practice on MATLAB, and if you need this code file, download it from more information section of this lecture video and stay tuned with us.
Hope you enjoyed this video. Please like, share and subscribe to our channel and also press the bell icon as we keep on posting informative content like this. You can also get certification from Tishitu Research Center if you finish minimum of 10 videos from the playlist. To get more information about this, connect to us at tishitu@gmail.com.